So Sam, you've beaten Dylan Andrews, you've beaten Dan Kelly in Australia. I guess you have good memories here.
I love Australia for more reasons than just the fights, but I've had some good fights here.
Was there any doubt about taking this fight on 2 weeks' notice?
No, I just kind of say yes to fights. It's always been my motto, and now it's my 17th fight in the UFC, so that motto's worked pretty well for me. I'm like Jim Carrey in the Yes Man. Just say yes, it'll all work itself out.
Well, I kind of answered my next question. When it's Australia, does that make it more appealing or a little bit more difficult because it's so far away?
I'd go appealing. I love traveling. I've always said in my career, I made almost no money until I made it to the UFC, almost nothing. And so every time I fought, I got to go somewhere. That's where I got paid, is I got to see different places. Now I'm in the UFC, I get paid and I get to see the world. And it's just, I get to bring my family, my wife, my kids. I get to bring people along with me, and it's magical.
When did you get here?
When did I get here? What day is today? it's funny. We've been doing the math. From where I'm from in California, it's 5 hours later, but then yesterday. So it's Thursday here. It's Wednesday home. I got here Monday here. Monday in Australia.
Would you have got here earlier if you'd known about the fight earlier?
Yeah. If it was a short notice fight, so I took every second I could get at my gym, and then I came out. But I'm feeling good. I'm ready for it. No jet lag, which I was really, even after my first two fights, I jet lagged a little bit. Nothing this time. I'm sleeping the whole night, waking up when I want to wake up, and not feeling good.
Amazing. Is there plans to hang around in Australia, in Melbourne, after the fight?
Yes. We're going to hang out for a day, and we're going to go out to Phillips Island. I hear there's penguins in Australia. They're probably deadly penguins, like you guys have deadly everything else. But we're going to go out and we're going to see them.
Brilliant. And you're fighting at 205. Is that a luxury, the fact that you can take fights at late notice? Or is it 185 pounds? Bit tougher?
Yes. I my last 185-pound fight I took on 10 days' notice, and I cut 42 pounds. I was supposed to cut 42 pounds. I made it to 40. And it was a mistake. My coaches tried to tell me no. I said, no, I can do it. I'm sure I can do it. And I came up about 2 pounds short. 205, it'll never be the case. I'm big enough to be 205. I'm built kind of like a 205. So at 205, I'll never get too big that I can't take a last-minute fight.
I guess fight week's a bit more fun fighting at 205.
Oh, fight week's so much more fun. I get to run a little bit. I get to walk around the city. We went and saw how to train a dragon yesterday. So it's a lot more fun.
What are your thoughts on the co-main event and the main event Saturday, Sunday morning?
So 8 weeks ago when they first announced Izzy versus Anderson, I was backstage at the Chuck Liddell Tito Ortiz fight, and I just came across my feed, and I called my wife and said, Britt, I need to get on this card. I want to be on this card with Anderson. So it worked, and it just didn't quite work out. They had already booked most of the card at that point. It just wasn't going to happen. And then they called and said, hey, you want on the Melbourne card? I said, yes. I am a fanboy of Anderson Silva. He's probably the only guy in the UFC that I haven't met him yet because I'm nervous to meet him, because I've got so much respect for him. He's the best that's ever been in this sport.
I agree. What are your thoughts on your opponent, Jimmy?
Jimmy's a stud. He's good everywhere. I don't see any real weaknesses, other than he's only has 9 fights, where I have over 50. And I think the experience is going to be a big advantage for me.
Did that make a big difference?
I really do. He can't put me anywhere I haven't been before. I've been taken down by Nate Marquardt. I fought, Rashad Evans. I fought some of the biggest and best in the sport, and I've been there. So I feel very confident with more than my training, just my experience, my wealth of knowledge in the sport.
Brilliant. Well, good luck.
Thank you very much, sir.
Cheers.